video tutorial on the issue of copyright. When we hear the word copyright, we might think it's a right to copy. Unfortunately, it's not. Copyright exactly means opposite. It means nobody can make a copy of this resource. Only the author or the creator has a right to use the resource and control the use of the resource. So the traditional copyright clause, which we see in the books that we may buy, has the C within a circle, as you can see on the slide in front of you. The slide shows a C with a circle around it in blue color. You will be seeing this copyright clause in the books in the inside cover, along with the phrase, all rights reserved. What it means is all the rights vest with the author, which is the right to make copies, right to modify, and right to share it with others. Now, the unfortunate thing about the copyright law is, even if this copyright clause is not mentioned in the creation, still it is subject to the same copyright law, which is all rights reserved. We may go to a website and find some interesting resource, and we may not find any copyright clause, and we may therefore think we can freely download and use it. No, you would be breaking the copyright law, because the default copyright law is that it's all rights reserved. Now, as teachers, we may want to share our materials that we create with others. In such a case, we need to explicitly use copyright law or copyright clauses that give rights to others to make copies and to modify. Thankfully, the Open Education Resources OER movement has created several copyright clause options for us which we can use. So the copyright that allows others to make copies of is called the Creative Commons Licensing. So traditional copyright has single C, and the Creative Commons Licensing intentionally uses double C. So if you just use the copyright clause double C or CC in your resource that you have created, it means other people can freely reuse it, they can make copies of it, and they can modify it as well. Now, if you want other people to give credit to you if you have authored a creation, you need to use a CC BY clause. So if you use a CC BY clause, it means other people can modify it, but they need to attribute the creation to you. The CC BY SA clause has an additional subclause of CA, which means share alike. Now, if somebody else takes the resource you have created, which you have licensed under CC BY SA, it means they can modify it, they can make copies of it. But if they modified it, the modified version should also have the license CC BY SA. So CC BY SA clause ensures that a resource that once is open, any variant of it also will continue to be open. It cannot become closed. The CC BY SA clause is also used by Wikipedia, and it's one of the popular Creative Commons licenses. So very simply, whenever you create a resource, which may be a video film, it may be an audio podcast, it may be a web page, it may be a text document, it may be an animation, or it may be a GeoGebra file, you need to mention in the file the author name, which is you. So say author, and then put your name, and alongside or below mention copyright dash CC BY SA. You can see the last line on the slide. So you have to say author, put your name, comma copyright dash CC BY SA. When you do that, you have made this resource as an OER, short for Open Education Resource. Every OER has four freedoms, or the four R's: the right to reuse, the right to revise, the right to remix, and the right to redistribute. As Wikipedia acknowledges, OER have provided enormous support and fillip to the open education and the open distance education movements. Why do we need OER? Schools and teachers have to be empowered to be able to freely use knowledge resources around them, as well as make their own contributions to the knowledge repositories in the world. And one of the important implications of this is also to create resources in local languages. For example, English pages on Wikipedia number more than 6 million, but there are only 26,000 pages in Kannada. Because Wikipedia is released as an OER under CC BY SA license, it means anybody can translate an existing English page to create or to populate a page in Kannada. So the spirit of CC BY SA, or the spirit of OER, acknowledges that knowledge builds on existing knowledge. So it's best that knowledge is available for free sharing, free adopting, adapting, and sharing. It's a virtuous cycle which will enable the knowledge of the world to keep increasing. Teachers have a special role in the case of OER. Teachers have to access existing OER, modify it, create their own, and share it with others and publish it for the use of all. The slide provides some name of popular OER repositories which you can create resource and publish to.